Good morning, students. Today we are going to find out the question and answer of the chapter. So first of all, we will see the section find out. In find out, there are two questions. The first one is, what laburnum is called in your language? The answer is, in our language, laburnum is called amaltas. The second question, which local bird is like the golden finch? A singing sparrow of yellow color is like the golden finch. While writing, write clearly, and there must not be the doodles in your handwriting, and never overline and underline the segments. Improve your handwriting. If you want to improve your handwriting, then try to see my another videos how to improve your handwriting, because the first impression of a student is of his handwriting. So please improve it. In the next segment, think it out. The first question is, what do you notice about the beginning and the ending of the poem? The laburnum tree is silent and still in the beginning of the poem. At the end of the poem, it is again the same. Means the question is there. So what is the difference and what kind of the difference we notice in the beginning and at the end of the poem? So I hope then there was no change, but in between there was a change. So that the same condition and the same situation is there in the beginning and in the end. So write it clearly. Second question, to what is the bird's movement compared? What is the basis for the comparison? The bird's movement has been compared to that of a lizard. Just as a lizard's movement is smooth, abrupt and full of carefulness, so is the movement of the bird. Next question. Why is the image of the engine evoked by the poet? The poet has evoked the image of the engine to bring out the role of the goldfinch. Just as an engine is the source of energy for the whole machine, so also the goldfinch is the source of energy for its young ones. She feeds them to their fill. Next question. What do you like most about the poem? Really, what do you like most about the poem? What? Think. Okay, let's answer. The poem has the quality of a picturesqueness. In it, first the laburnum is shown to silent and still in the autumnal afternoon of a September day. Secondly, the tree is set abuzz as soon as goldfinch enters its nest to feed it brood. Finally, the tree falls silent as it was in the beginning. All these phases of the tree are beautifully painted. Similarly, the movements of the bird are aptly compared to that of lizard. Sleek, alert and abrupt. We like the manner in which the poet makes us perceive the whole scene. Means three segments are there of this poem. The first, the silent tree, and the last one is again the silent, and the middle one is really important when the goldfinch comes and the chorus begins. So this is the right reply of the question. Next question, fifth question. What does the phrase her bird face identity mask mean? Here the question itself tells the question. Bird face identity means people recognize us with our face. They see our eyes and they see our nose, the lips, and they try to recognize who is he. The same happens in birds also. They have some barred on their face. Bar means the lines, and identity mask. So these bar are the identity for the bird. The goldfinch has a barred face. Such a face is her identity. It serves as a mask that helps people and its young ones identify the goldfinch. Very good. Note down segment, we will see the sounds, words. Yeah, there are so many words. They are the sounds like twitching. When the sound is of twitching, twitch, 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 chirp, that's chir chin chin chun chi chi chi. So twitching and chirping, the same sounds they are. Chittering, so chitter bitter, when we have the chittering sounds. Tremor of wings, when somebody uses their wings, and the trembling sounds, the vibration of the wings, that is the tremor of wings. Trilling sounds, visual chirps, and whispering. So talking silently. So these are the words, these are telling their sounds itself. So actually these are the sound and the words. The movement words. In this poem there are some words that tells about the movements, like fallen, suddenness, startlement, trembles, stalks, flirts out, and launches away. These are the words that tells us about the movement. These are not silent, these are not still. There is a movement in these words, and they tells us about the movements of the poem. Third question. Note down segment, third question. The dominant color in the poem. In the beginning, we can see the aburnum leaves, and they are turning yellow, and the flowers of aburnum, that is again yellow, and the daylight of September, that is yellow. So I think yellow color is dominant color in this poem. There are three more questions, or list the followings. So how can we find it out the words which describes sleek, alert, and abrupt. Word which describes sleek, alert, and abrupt are suddenness and startlement. So the meaning of these, the same those they have, sleek and abrupt and alert. This is called suddenness and startlement. Words with the sound ch as in chart, and tr as in trembles in the poem. So words with the sound ch are goldfinch, twittering, chittering, branch, chirp, and launches. So ch is pronounced ch here, so it is in the category of the word that is that has ch, but the pronunciation is ch. And words with the sound tr, that is tr, are trembles, trilling, tremor, and tree. So these are the sounds, these are pronounced like tr, and ch is pronounced ch, though it is also pronounced sh, like in mustache. Okay, other sounds that occur frequently in the poem. Answer: L and R, means L and R is pronounced L and R, and to occur in the poem. It comes so many time. Very good. So this is the end of slide and end of the question. And thanks for watching. Keep coming regularly on our channel and try to know so many things. Thanks a lot again.